7:17 right now, Friday night, last Friday evening, I came to a taping of the Golden Girls and watched four pros at work. Afterwards, we all sat down in their living room.
B. Arthur, Betty White, Rue McClanahan, Estelle Getty. Each are so gifted. And together, of course, they're the Golden Girls, and we're sitting where they do their thing every week. Ladies, good morning. Good evening. Here it is, the end of the day. It's what, 10:30, 11 o'clock at night. You have just done your taping, the end of your week. What is your feeling right now as you finish this whole crunch when it's finally over on Friday night? What's it feel like right
Relief.
Now?
Relief.
Thank God.
Did you get a look at Rue's feet?
We got through another one.
Each of you has had such a major career. I mean, you are all so successful. You have so much experience in theater and television and movies and so on and so on.
Oh, I like him.
Like
and
him?
He's tall.
He's too tall for me.
Nobody's too tall for me.
What is it like at this point in your careers when you have so much behind you, all of a sudden be sitting on this hit or sitting in the middle of a real smash?
It's not bad.
Unbelievable.
Until this program, most leading women were, you know, younger, glamorous, didn't have the kind of didn't have the kind of layers of life experience, right? Those leading women. And here you all are together in concert with a smash hit. How concerned were each of you at the beginning that so many viewers wouldn't respond?
We've talked about this before. When I read the script, I never thought, well, these are middle-aged people. I just thought we were regular people in a terrifically witty, adult, bright script. And I just assumed that...
But it is true that there was so much talk about the age situation when we went on. The network came to Susan Harris and said, could you address a show to this age bracket? And she said, I'd love to. I've been dying to, but nobody would touch it because it was of that given age. We say things on the show that if we were 20, 25, 30 years younger, it would be salacious. It would be objectionable. We've been around the track a couple of times, and we can say it and get away with it.
Some of the people out there don't know that we have writers. They think we make this up.
We get letters. We get letters all the time saying, how much do they write and how much is yours? They write it all. Believe me, we don't ad lib at all.
There's an article out now. Is no matter how successful anything is, they're always going to be the critics. Who suggest, this one writer suggests, that with all these wonderful characters, with the wonderful writing, the depth, the maturity, the ensemble, all the positive things, that too many times the writers will go for jokes, go for yucks, implying that, you know, that it ain't good enough the way it is. You gotta go for quick one-liners just to make sure you keep the laughs coming up to it. How do you react to hearing a critic write that about what you're doing?
It's character humor. It's not one-line jokes. All the humor comes out of the characters that we play.
Besides, she did admit in the article that she'd only seen three shows out of this season. And that's not really a very good representation. I wanted to write an article in 2 years when we're still going strong and say, gee, they did
it. Well, I think it's a fear everybody should have. Because sooner or later, writers are going to be leaving to go on and produce other shows. And who knows where we'll be. But, you know, to thine own self be true. What else can you do?
Did I say that? Wonderful
yes, writers. I'm going to do that in Needlepoint.
Of course, you've been together a while now. What is it like? Try to describe it if you can.
Oh. May I just give you a little example? The other day, about a week ago, Rue came in and just offhand said, it's beginning to hit me. We've only got six more shows to do this season.
This year.
And it's beginning to get to me. That's how we feel. It's like kids going off to camp.
It really
and
is.
What are we going to do without each other for all summer?
Congratulations, you all.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks for letting us share.
You look
share
wonderful
all this
without makeup, by the way.
Thank you.
And he's so tall.